Hey guys, welcome to D3D5. My name is Saurav. If you love 3D printing and want to know more about it, then please subscribe to this channel. And by the end of this video, you will learn how to print this object. Let's go and print.
While designing a 3D model or 3D printing, you will encounter a variety of file types used. Here's a list of some common file extensions you will see in 3D printing. First, OBJ. It is an open file format that represents 3D geometry and is commonly used in 3D printing because many design softwares export to OBJ and most printers accept OBJ as a printable file. Next is STL. It is a standard file format that interfaces between CAD software and 3D printer. Most CAD softwares can export to an STL file. Next, VRML or WRL. These file types are commonly used when a 3D model has a color and you want to transfer that color to the print. Next is X3G. It is a file type that interfaces with the MakerBot. MakeWay or Replicator G will output X3G files. Next is PLY. These files are normally scanner generated models. Next, FBX. It is a file format owned by Autodesk. It is used to efficiently exchange data between Autodesk programs like 3ds Max, Autodesk Maya. Now we move to the designing part. If you already know how to design a 3D model, then you can skip to the part where we import this design into the slicer program. The software we are using is Autodesk Fusion 360. The simplest way to create our cube is by using the Create Box option. In the model menu under the Create drop-down, we have an option called Box. This will create a box of our desired dimensions. We need a box of 20x20mm. For creating the hollow part inside, under the Modify menu, we have a command called Shell. This will remove the material from the interior of the box, creating a cavity with walls of specified thickness, that is 2mm. Another way to create the cube is by sketching squares. In this, we use the center point rectangle, creating a square of 20x20mm and inner square with side 16, keeping 2mm offset from both sides. Now coming back to the model menu, we can extrude the squares as desired. Selecting the squares and extruding it 2mm and the outer square to a height of 20mm. This is the shape required. Or simply, we can extrude the whole box to a height of 20mm and remove the inner part with cut option or pocket option. Now finally, our cube is ready and we need to export this file to the slicer program. I've selected the file type as STL. After exporting, the next part is importing this file into the slicer program. The slicing software we are using is Cura. It is a free source software most commonly used, and it has more features compared to the other slicing softwares. In the future videos, we are going to learn more about this slicing software and also all types of 3D printing files, like I mentioned, STL, OBJ and many more. Now let's start with first importing our file, that is test cube print. Let's change the print orientation of the cube. Now set the layer height. For now, we are printing in 0.2 mm, that is a medium layer height. Then select the infill density for 20%, that describes the strength of the object. For now, we are taking 20%. In the future videos, we are going to learn more about it in detail. Select the print temperature according to the filament. As we are printing with PLA, we are setting it to 190 degrees Celsius and for the bed, it is 45. For PLA, bed temperature is not required, but for our object to stick to the bed, we have kept this temperature. Selecting the speed at which we want to print. For now, we consider 45 mm per second. At this print speed, print will come off with a very good detailed print. All things set, we are good to go now. Let's slice it. It shows 43 minutes and weight is 4 gram. Well, now save this G-code file which is created by Cura. And send to printer via SD card and print it.
After watching this tutorial, I hope you guys have understood how to print an object, from designing to using the slicing software to printing the object. If you guys have got any doubt regarding any of the steps, then please write down in the comment below so that we can answer it out. Also, if you want your object or design to be 3D printed, then there is a link in the description box. Please go and check it out. Thank you for watching.